Live and direct from the Golden State, it's Intelligent Talk Media, the Denice Gary Show. Now, here's Denice Gary.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining me again today, Wednesday, for the Denice Gary Show. I want to remind all of you about Dane Anderson. We talked about his case just last week, and as you know, he's had to undergo skin grafts over his entire body. He was in a medically induced coma. From everything I hear, just an outstanding young man here in our community and in the Bakersfield area. Would you please just say your prayers for him and his family? I believe it was yesterday, if I'm not mistaken, he underwent surgery. Again, he underwent surgery over almost every area of his body. So I imagine that the pain is horrific. And so please, let's keep him in our prayers, and let's keep, you know, I think about veterans and veterans that are burn victims. Let's keep all of our burn victims in our prayers. That is such a terribly painful, long-suffering issue to have to deal with. So let's keep Dane Anderson, and of course, let's always keep our veterans in our prayers and those that are fighting and on active duty around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, as you may know, as I've talked about this before, we have men in Special Forces and the Marine Corps. We have people all over the globe in approximately 75 to 80 countries, and they're fighting wars to secure the peace, to hinder and prohibit Islamic terrorism. So let's keep all of them in our prayers, as well as our intelligence officers. I wanted to start off today talking about Dolores Huerta. Dolores Huerta staged a press conference, but you know, it's more than a press conference. You know, it's a protest outside Congressman Kevin McCarthy's door. And I wanted to let you know that this is not irregular, that she will go there and she will protest. And of course, what she's protesting, and I will read her words. She says, "We know that right here in this office," again, she's standing there with her crowd in front of Congressman McCarthy's office. She says, "We know that right here in this office, we have one of the most powerful people in the U.S. Congress, and he has the authority and he has the power to let these voices be heard, the voices that are behind me right now, to say we need a fair immigration bill." So I wanted to let you know that there are regular protests, and I also want you to be aware of the fact that people that are involved in those protests may often be illegal immigrants. And I'd like to say to Dolores Huerta and her followers that it's really important for you, when you're feeling sad and brokenhearted about child separation from their mothers or from their parents, to appreciate the fact that the President of the United States last week signed an executive order to remedy laws that were passed by Democrats during the Clinton and Obama years. And so this president, it's important, Dolores Huerta, and your followers, to understand that we don't make decisions based on emotion. We make decisions based on the rule of law. This is not Mexico, this is not Honduras, and this is not Guatemala. And to those Democrats like Dolores Huerta, who will say we need, the American taxpayers need to spend more money in Honduras or Guatemala or other Central American countries, I want you to know this, ladies and gentlemen. The United States of America has just spent over $1 billion in Honduras. We just spent over $1 billion in Guatemala. We just spent over another $1 billion in a Central American country. And we spend tremendous amounts, billions of dollars, to help Mexico and to try to help remedy the narco-terrorism that's in that country. So please understand that while my heart breaks and your heart breaks, and we can be together on that one issue that it's heartbreaking. The point is, Dolores Huerta, and the point is for those of you that follow her, that she needs to say to her followers, you need to obey the law. And if you obey the law, your children will not be separated for any length of time. Whereas we have families here in California that are separated permanently from their children because their children were killed by illegal immigrants. So let's get it all in perspective. We have a group of people over here that are permanently separated from their children forever after. And we have people that are temporarily separated from their children because they broke the law. So let's put things in context. Let's look at the bigger picture. And let's say to the mothers and fathers that are showing up on the California border with Mexico illegally, as opposed to going to a legal port of entry. And ladies and gentlemen, that's all they need to do is go to a legal port of entry. And if they claim, and believe me, they've been coached. They've been coached by human traffickers. They've been coached by the cartels. They've been coached by coyotes. They've been coached to say, I'm in fear of losing my life. If I go back into Mexico or Guatemala or Honduras or any other Central American country, they've been coached. So Dolores Huerta, you know, try to understand that it's important for you as a leader of the Latino community that you tell people the truth, and that this president and the Republicans in the House and the Senate are trying to pass legislation, and that the leadership in the House and the Senate run by Democrats, the leadership that's run by Democrats, have refused to cooperate with passing a legitimate and ethical immigration bill. Those are the facts. Try to keep that in mind and try to encourage, as a Latino leader, the Latino people that are coming up here illegal and trying to sneak into the United States illegally or hoping for catch and release, as happened under the Obama administration, that we finally have a real leader, the President of the United States, who has the backbone and the guts to stand up to people like you who want us to have a lawless society with open borders. That's not the way to run a country, and that's not the way for a president to secure the safety and security of Americans who are paying taxes to local law enforcement, to the FBI, to the CIA, to the President of the United States to maintain our safety. That's their job. Okay, moving on. It also came to my attention that the California Democrat that's sitting there now in the Senate, her name is Kamala Harris. We talked about her yesterday. It's come to my attention that an Iraqi war veteran, this is an Iraqi war veteran that is disabled here in the Golden State, reached out to Kamala Harris and told her that illegal immigrants had stolen his identity. Now, we're talking about a disabled war veteran. I don't know if he's from Kern County or not. It doesn't matter. He's here in California, and he reached out to Kamala Harris when she was the Attorney General before Javier Becerra, and she is refusing to help out a disabled Iraqi war veteran. Unbelievable. So, ladies and gentlemen, when you go to the polls and vote in November of 2018, you need to remember that people like California Senator Kamala Harris and Javier Becerra, the California Attorney General, these are people that are working towards helping people that are breaking the law so that they can enter the country, as opposed to helping a veteran who was willing to risk his life and limb in the service of maintaining the safety and security of every American. Let's remember that. And speaking about going to the polls, let me remind you, it's Stephen Bailey. He's the retired California Superior Court judge here in California. He is running against Javier Becerra. So when you look at your ballot in November, it's a check for Stephen Bailey, retired California Superior Court judge. Let's move on. Now, Next thing I wanted to get to, oh, my producer told me I got to take a break. Well, before we take a break, I want to say this. So, just found out before coming into the studio today, maybe some of you have heard, gotten the word, that Supreme Court Justice Kennedy is retiring from the court. And he sent a letter to the president. And I don't know if that letter, let me just take a look and see if it comes up. No, it doesn't. Okay. So he sent a letter, I believe it was yesterday, but please don't quote me on that. I believe that Justice Kennedy, Supreme Court Justice Kennedy, sent a letter to the president in which he said that he was providing respectful and formal notification of his decision to step down from the Supreme Court. I believe he's 81 years of age, 81-year-old senior associate justice, has let the White House know, saying that he respectfully and was formally giving notification to the President of the United States that he would step down effective July 31st. Now, some people say that Justice Kennedy, who was appointed by who? Ronald Reagan. He was an appointee by Ronald Reagan, that he's giving the president an opportunity before the elections to put forth a conservative judge. This is so important, and I'll tell you, I'll give you an important reason why. Where was I? I was reading something. Think about this. Judges are so important for so many reasons. The Supreme Court on yesterday, ruled 5-4 in favor of a pro-life crisis pregnancy centers in California. This is a California issue because the Democrats in California passed a law in 2011. The Democrats in California passed a law in 2011 called the FACT, F-A-C-T, the FACT Act, that said that a pro-life crisis pregnancy center had to make it clear that they were not in the business of providing abortion. So there was the aim of the passage of that 2011 FACT Act by the Democrats was to discourage and prevent women from seeking abortions. That's what the FACT Act says, that the purpose of these pro-life sinners is to discourage and prevent women from seeking abortions. Isn't that terrible? Isn't that terrible that a pro-life pregnancy center would maybe say to a young woman who's contemplating ripping a baby out limb by limb out of her womb, torturing an infant because you know they feel pain. They certainly feel pain by the end of the fourth month. We know that definitely because the expressions of on their faces have been recorded. These are premature babies, and they suffer horrific pain because their little nerve endings are developing. Whoops, sorry about that. So their little nerve endings are developing, and they suffer critical pain, horrific pain. They're being tortured. So the Democrats passed a law because they didn't want women to be discouraged from getting an abortion. Let's not just look at the torture of what an infant goes through. Let's look at what that woman goes through. Maybe not the year she gets her child aborted, or the next year, or the next year. But most women get to a point in their life, and this is well documented, they begin to feel horrific pain over the idea that they destroyed a human being inside themselves. And it begins to weigh heavy on their mind and their heart. And it leads to depression. It can lead to suicide, because ultimately women may in fact feel terrible about the experience. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, if you carry a baby to term, you can give that baby up for adoption. There are people in Kern County, there are people in our state, there are people in the nation that are standing in line to adopt infants. My own sister adopted two children. I tried to adopt children. I went through the foster care system, though, so ultimately families were found for the foster children that I took in, that I tried to adopt, and that really broke my heart, and that sent me through a really very sad period of time in my life, because I was trying to adopt a little bit older children, and when the family members were finally found, that was very sad, but for me anyway. But the point that I'm making is that the Democrats are not promoting our Judeo-Christian values, and this is key. And so we tell your friends, share this show out to everybody you know. Say you've got to get to the polls, we've got to vote Republican, because we don't know ultimately if we're going to have enough votes to get in another conservative Supreme Court judge. And this will be essential. This could be a page turner in the history of the United States of America. Think of it. This could be tremendously historic. It might mean overturning Roe v. Wade. I mean, this has huge significance. So ladies and gentlemen, I've got to go to a commercial break. And by the way, please listen to these commercials and support these businesses. These people are helping me pay the bills, and I appreciate them so much. And show your appreciation for them and for the fact that they're advertising on the Denice Scary Show. Thank you so much, and we'll be right back with so much more.
I want to tell you about a place I love to go. Frugati's Italian Restaurant. Very few locations here provide seating outside in front of a fabulous water fountain with an atmosphere that is reminiscent to me of eating outdoors in Venice. This is real Italian food by real Italians. And what makes it even more so is owner Ralph Frugoletti, who nearly a quarter century ago brought a wood fire oven from Milan, Italy to make, like his mother, fresh homemade bread and pizzas. Moreover, Frugati's Restaurant offers you not only the very best in southern Italian cooking, even importing the finest ingredients for authentic Italian food, including a fitness menu. After all, Ralph has represented the United States in Italy, competing in the Master Championship Games. He knows all the right food for good fitness, so check out the menu. After today's broadcast, run over to Frugati's Italian Restaurant and Catering at 600 Coffee Road here in Bakersfield. And after a Friday, Saturday, or Sunday service, stop into Frugati's for a great lunch. I'll see you there, and tell Mr. Ralph Frugoletti that Denice sent you. Salute. Buon appetito.
Ladies and gentlemen, when it comes to legal matters, contact Barb Reynolds. She is a contract paralegal to lawyers, and she will take good care of you. Moreover, she is a Kern County legal document assistant to pro-per litigants. She has 47 years of paralegal experience, and for over 30 years has been an educator in the field of law and paralegal work. If you need help handling your adoption, bankruptcy, civil suit, divorce, debt consolidation, evictions, immigration, or attorney referrals, contact Barb Reynolds if you want to win your case. Call Tehachapi Court Services today at 661-822-1994. Barb is simply the best. Call Tehachapi Court Services today at 661-822-1994. Ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about Recover Your Cub. From everyone I've spoken to, Recover Your Cub at Tehachapi Municipal Airport is the place for you to go. If you've got an aircraft and you want to get it restored, you want it cleaned, washed, detailed, you want interior modifications made, you want aircraft modifications, maintenance, you're looking for a rental facility, you're looking for a hangar, you want to lease a hangar, you want to park your aircraft, call Ken Hetke. Ken Hetke. 661-822-2827. Again, Ken Hetke at 822-2827, area code 661. Ladies and gentlemen, he's received an A++++ rating for his service. For individuals that have gone to work with Ken Hetke. Also, ladies and gentlemen, he is the councilman there in Tehachapi, and I understand he does a lot of great work up there for the City Council of Tehachapi. And I also understand, in talking to people from the area, that he has really volunteered his time to do some great humanitarian work. This is a great citizen. And I hope that you'll support Ken Hetke. Again, let's give out the number one more time. 661-822-2827. Call Ken Hetke. He'll take care of you. Okay, let's move on. I want to talk about one of the local writers here for the Bakersfield Californian, Robert Price. The Bakersfield Californian is a local newspaper for those of you that will be listening in Northern and Southern California. One of the questions that Robert Price, a local newspaper writer, wrote was, who is Kevin McCarthy working for? Those of you who know Kevin McCarthy, that who have seen him on Fox News or CNN or one of the other leading networks, Kevin McCarthy is the majority leader for the Republicans in the House of Representatives. And I actually wanted to address Robert Price directly. Robert, I read your piece. The point of Robert Price's article is that Congressman McCarthy is not properly representing the district because, he says, local growers need to find workers to harvest their crops, and he feels that Kevin McCarthy's Republican leadership in Washington is driving them away. And this came out yesterday, and I just wanted to address that. You know, ladies and gentlemen, there was a day in the United States of America, and right here in the agricultural fields of Kern County, and by the way, I understand that the county of Kern provides 60% to 70% of the agriculture to areas around the country, and I appreciate that, but there was a day when Americans were recruited, where Californians, where people right here in Kern County were recruited to go work in the fields. I remember hearing about and knowing high schoolers and college students that were looking for work. And now many of those high schoolers that are looking for summer jobs or needing to work their senior year in high school and have a work permit and can do so, and those entering college and working their way through college, you're looking at a woman that worked her way through school. I worked in high school, I worked my way through college and through university, worked my way through graduate school, which was really tough. Not a lot of sleep during those years. And ladies and gentlemen, I know what it is to work hard, but there are many young people out there today that are willing to work just as hard. I remember working three jobs just so I could begin graduate school. So there are young people right here. There are young people in your city, in your county, that need work. If growers here in Kern County, or workers, they ought to reach out within their local communities. They ought to reach out and recruit citizens of the United States first. Isn't that what the president says? You know, let's focus on making sure that every American has a job, right? Let's make sure those young people are employed. I can't tell you how many young people that are just like me, as I was when I was in my younger years. They want to save their money. They want to go to college, or they want to pay their way through a vocational school. And you know, vocational school isn't free, nor should it be. There are many vocational programs. I know through the Regional Occupation Center, through the Kern High School District, Bakersfield Adult School. There are other vocational ed programs that teach people a trade and a skill. Those programs aren't, you know, free. They cost money. So, you know, I would say to Robert Price that was calling Kevin McCarthy out on this, I'd say, you know what, let's go out there and let's recruit our young people. Let's recruit college students. Let's recruit people who are unskilled individuals here in our own communities. Let's go out there to the homeless community. Let's offer those homeless people an opportunity to get out there and work in the fields and earn an honest day's wage. Let's make it happen. Also, I thought it was interesting that Bakersfield, Californian writer Robert Price also criticized McCarthy on the tariffs issue, saying he was standing with the president. Let's talk about that for a moment. I want to say this, that the president of the United States, when he was meeting with our European partners, one of the things he said to our European partners on trade, let's all of us set aside our tariffs. you know, if Canada ends its tariff, if the French and the British and the Germans, if we all just set aside our tariffs and just have free trade, let's do it. But you know what? It takes strength of character. It takes a belief in your principles to say, you know what? Why is it that the United States of America, I know that our growers sell food in China. I was married to a grower once upon a time. And I had dinner with people from China that we were involved in trade with. I understand what that's all about. And I understand that we're involved. Our growers here in Kern County in the San Joaquin Valley are selling a lot to India. India and China, I get it. We're also selling to European nations as well. We're also selling on the East Coast and all over. I get that. But the bottom line is, if we're supposed to, why is it that the United States of America, why should California growers insist that China keep up protective tariffs, but we, on the other hand, don't protect our industries here in California, here in the San Joaquin Valley and throughout the country? So this is what I say to Robert Price. Write an article that's truly fair to the people of the United States, to the growers here in California and throughout the state of California. Let's say to everyone, drop the tariffs. Let's just engage in free trade. But if the United States is to drop protective tariffs, then everybody else does too, including China and including India. I want to say one other thing before I go. I know I've got a class to go to tonight, and I just found out, just coming home last night from a class, and I turned on the news, of course, as I always do when I get home, and I found out that somebody left a mutilated animal, which, of course, hurts me because I love animals. I rescue animals. I won't tell you how many animals I've rescued over the years. But this was an animal that was mutilated, and the head of this animal was decapitated. The animal was decapitated and burned, and it was left on the front porch of a Department of Homeland Security employee. This is evil. And I don't know if you're aware of it, but Maxine Waters, I just read this. This came out today. Maxine Waters says she stands by her speech and calling on Democrats to harass people that work for the Department of Homeland Security. This has got to end, and I'm going to ask all of you to call Congress. I want you to call this number. Get a piece of paper and get a pencil. Write this down. 202-224-3121. 202-224-3121. Call Congress. This is what I'm going to ask you to do. I'm going to ask you first thing tomorrow morning is to call them and say, you want Maxine Waters and Kamala Harris, because Kamala Harris is right there with her. Kamala Harris is standing with Maxine Waters. I want you to call for their resignation. Kamala Harris is in the Senate. She's our senator from California. I want you to call for Kamala Harris to be censured. I want you to call for the censorship of Maxine Waters. She's in the House of Representatives. I want you to call and demand that they resign from office and that they be censored by Congress. This needs to happen. We cannot have a senator and a woman sitting in the Congress, the House of Representatives, calling for people that are involved in public service who actually believe it's important to uphold the rule of law in the United States. We are not a nation based on emotion and based on people's desire to break the law. I understand that people are calling ICE agents, immigration officers, Nazis. Yeah, we don't commit genocide here in the United States, and we're not throwing people into gas chambers and ovens. So, you know what, that's just so ridiculous and off the wall. You need, and ladies and gentlemen, if you see a Democrat, that's what you say. If you're going to call officers of the law a Nazi, would you please remind them that there's no one in the United States of America that is even thinking or contemplating genocide? That our law enforcement officials, we're not into genocide, we're not throwing people into ovens and gas chambers. So let's be responsible with our free speech. Let's be respectful to the other side. We have people that disagree, so let's not interrupt people and be rude in a public setting. Wait your turn to speak. And don't name call. Let's not name call. Let's be respectful. Let's be polite. If you don't know how to be polite, go buy a book called Amy Vanderbilt's Book of Manners. Find out. Find out how to exercise your free speech rights in a respectful and civil way. And let's not put the bodies of burned animals that have been decapitated on the doorsteps of people that are devoting their lives to public service. Let's not call Republicans Nazis. Let's just maintain some civility in the public discourse of ideas. And let's remind those Democrats, those leftists, those liberal progressives, that the president has signed an executive order to bring these families together that have broken the law, and that these individuals can have conversations with their parents and be reunited. And this will happen. And let's be encouraging, and let's work towards that. Why don't you people on the left, liberal Democrats, why don't you progressives, why don't you socialist little Marxists running around, why don't you call the Department of Homeland Security and say, how can I help? How can I help in a detention facility to make sure that there's enough phones so that everybody can reach out and talk to their parents? How can I help? Maybe provide clothing or toys or educational supplies. What can I do to be part of the solution? How can I make things better? That's what we need to ask ourselves. How can we make things better in a respectful and thoughtful manner? Let's think about that going forward, ladies and gentlemen. I want to thank you so much. I had several other things that I wanted to talk. I didn't even get to the cities here in California. There's 20 zones here in California that are trying to pass zone codes so that gun stores cannot lawfully sell a gun. There are 20 cities in the state of California. I'll have to get to that story tomorrow. Bit of a teaser for all of you. There's so much more, and I want to thank you for tuning in. Please share this broadcast. I'm working on trying to promote my broadcasts, and again, looking for more advertisers, sponsors for the show. So thank you so much. If you'd like to be a sponsor and support this broadcast, let me know. The more dollars I have, the more ability I will have going forward to promote these broadcasts and increase the numbers. Again, one way we can do it together is by sharing this broadcast out. So thank you so much for listening. Thank you for sharing. Appreciate all of you. Look forward to being right back with you tomorrow on Thursday. Thank you so much for tuning into the Denice Gary Show. This is Denice signing off.
Thank you for listening to The Denice Gary Show. Intelligent talk media.